when is our minimum and when is our maximum temperature we should expect each day on average. So let's start off with essentially a profile that shows solar radiation, the amount of incoming shortwave solar radiation, and this should be very familiar if you've been following along, and we should know that it's going to be highest at, let's just call it solar noon, and so this is a 12-hour day, so this must be an equinox or on the equator, which we have a 6 a.m. sunrise and a 6 p.m. sunset. So this is essentially the time during the day in which solar radiation is coming in and to us at the surface. Now, going out is Earth's radiation back out. That's long wave, outgoing. Think of it as heat. So we can also think of that as being temperature. And so our Earth is essentially being heated by the sun, and that Earth is then radiating that heat back outward through our atmosphere and back into space. So when on average would we find the lowest or the minimum temperature would actually be just after the sunrise. And so in this case, about 6:10 or 6:15 a.m. is when the lowest temperature we should expect. Why is it just after sunrise? It's because there's a little bit of a lag. So that it takes some time for that heat, for that solar energy to actually start then heating up the surface. So it's coming through the atmosphere and it takes a certain amount. It's not instantaneous. It's not all of a sudden the solar energy is there and boom, it takes some time. It's a little sluggish. It takes about 10, 15 minutes for it to start to get then to a warming trend, and then it obviously peaks. And so then this next point I'm trying to make is the maximum temperature. You would think, well, wait a minute, it would be when the solar noon, it'd be when the sun is at its highest point. It's when it's its most powerful and most direct. Yes, that's true. It's at its most direct, but it's not until about 3 p.m., 3 to 4 p.m. on average is when the maximum daily temperature would be found. So if you've ever been in the afternoon in a hot summer day is actually when the temperature is the highest. It's not there right at 12 noon. And so once again, there's a lag here. And so you're still getting a good amount of solar energy. Yeah, it's going down, but it's still quite high as we see here in this graphic. And so it's still quite high. So it's once again, trying to emphasize the point that it's not at noon when you'd have the highest temperature. It's a little bit later in the afternoon because you're still getting a good amount of radiation. Now, eventually the outgoing radiation exceeds the incoming. And so then of course the temperature then starts to go down.